PEGI 18.
My name is Little Jimmy Urine from Mindless Self Indulgence, and I play the voice of Zed, and I'm scoring all the boss battles for Lollipop Chainsaw. If I could describe Lollipop Chainsaw in three words, it would be totally fucking crazy.
Yamaoka desu. Grasshopper de CC o creative no direction to sound no design o yatte imasu. Lollipop Chainsaw ってそのすごく非現実、すごいフィクションの世界観が盛りだくさん含まれてますね。このゲームの世界観を作るのに80年代の音楽っていうのはすごい意識しましたね。なんでかというと、80年代の音楽ってすごく一回聴いただけでこう忘れないっていうか、すごく印象的だったりするって音楽があって、そのノリというかその雰囲気をこのロリポップチェーンソーでもちょっと描きたいなと思って、ちょっとすごく参考にしましたね。
It's all crammed in there, and it's from all different types of styles. So you have everything from like new bands like Sleigh Bells and Skrillex to really cool punk rock bands like the Toy Dolls. A lot of the inspiration and reference points really came from the actual characters themselves. They're all very specific and unique. The character I play, Zed, is a punk rock zombie, so I started with that sort of as a basis. VK, the Viking, has a very metal feel. So we start with all these bases of sort of the style of the zombie. And then I would start to really fuck it up and, you know, chop it up and really make it a little bit more crazy.
それをゲームの中に取り入れてくれたっていうのありますよね。で、僕らはゲーム音楽作ってる人は、先ほど言ったようにそのゲームありきというか、ゲームで沿ったような音楽を考えるんですけど、ジミーさんはそこを純粋に音楽っていう価値で、音楽っていうバリューで、ロリポップチェーンソーに音楽を提供してくれたっていうのは、すごく大きなことなのかなと思います。
I think what fans are really going to enjoy about Lollipop Chainsaw, besides the fact that it's a really cool game, is the fact that it's sort of like a big art project. There's a certain element of everything but the kitchen sink thrown into it. And this is just sort of an over-the-top, crazy, cult, underground game, which is, I think, what is very appealing about it.